eating ass till Shad told me, like, bro, you gotta do it. And Shad got it from this nigga. So yeah, like
I told this nigga back in high school, no, you a nasty nigga, I'm not doing that shit.
Bro, but that's what y'all all told me in school, bro.
This is the thing,
they literally all told the whole this nigga, school told me this.
This nigga's a so tree of youth or something.
So check it. No, listen though. No, he was doing this shit before Trick Daddy.
No, but listen though, check it.
Before Lil B, before Kevin Gates.
Yeah, this real shit though. All of that, before bro. That shit got cool, like I didn't want to tell nobody what I was doing.
Bro, I swear to God, bro, I took all the jokes, bro. All the jokes from you niggas, bro. I'm not smoking with you no more. All of that, I took every joke, bro. I made that shit cool, bro.
Right.
On God. Look,
listen. All right, in my high school days, bitches was fucking with older niggas. Like, they picking these bitches up from school. So I'm thinking, what? How can I one-up these niggas?
I'm going to lick some butt.
How can dirt. I one-up these niggas? You hear me? I got you. Bitch, come here. Ah.
Yeah. Change that wife on niggas.
And then that shit changed my life, oh, no. Nigga. Can't and I was happy as fuck, too.
I'm going to set my grandma on this shit. Yeah.
Hey, my grandma watch this shit.
I'll be damned. I'll take my granny in this shit, boy.
My granny gonna
we got
be
Sunday
like,
dinner coming up. She gonna see me.
Why are you talking about licking ass on television like that?
She gonna be like, boy, get you a do plastic.
Do you think them old niggas was doing that shit?
No.
I don't want to think about my grandma getting her ass licked, bro. What are you talking about? Ew. But brother,
See, I wouldn't even. I didn't say nothing about his grandma.
Because we were talking about
I
old
just said
people.
Old niggas in general.
Old niggas are definitely
was
doing it.
Upon that
old
shit.
Niggas
was,
bro,
nah, but we got it from somewhere.
Because, bro, you, yeah.
Game is passed upon, nigga.
Yeah, I think it's just for me. It was curiosity, though.
Curiosity, looking ass.
I wonder where did that shit start?
So you think it was? You think it was some old niggas before you? Curious?
Nah, it was some old freaky ass niggas looking butt.
It still is.
Don't you look that shit up?
Where the eating ass start?
That's some medieval shit. I ain't gonna hold you, bro. That's some shit.
I black like, legs.
It was some torture man. Shit, bro.
No, but it's just that's like not... I don't know, bro. Because like,
should I look up who was? No, I'm just gonna look when the, who no who should, or should I look at who was the first
nigga to eat some ass?
Nah, they ain't gonna be fun.
They got
that.
A good Google on that.
Cause fuck around, it was a slave looking master's
nah,
wife. Butt.
But look though, this the thing though. It like
my bad, I'm a little fucked up. So.
If you're
if you get the feeling, if you get the feeling too freaky,
when like, did people start eating?
Cause like when you just like when you ain't sober, really when you up. Sober, you just licking that motherfucker with the tip of your tongue.
The fuck I am.
But then when you get when
you drink, it's the
in that motherfucker.
What?
How you doing?
The whole palate.
What? In that motherfucker. You just licking that motherfucker.
Don't let me be off some hen dog. Oh, what? I'm trying to put my whole tongue in the hole. What are you talking about?
Hey, bro, I ain't gonna. Boy, what?
What? Say, twin?
I be drunk.
You know the vibes on God, bro. What?
Oh, this motherfucker just took me
off. I'm about to
try to blow in that motherfucker.
Boy, you hear me? I'm about to get that motherfucker CPR.
That's crazy. Shout out that nigga said he's taking a bong shot at that motherfucker.
I'm about to make animal balloons in
what?
This when I blow the bitch your ass.
God forbid.
Blowing that motherfucker. Hey. Never mind, man. I'm a saint.
Hey, man, we back, man. Fuck is y'all talking about, man? This episode is called Just Press Play. Fuck is y'all talking about, man? To my left, Hector Juan Carlos.
Yes, sir.
Far right, Tego.
Dontego Casanova, a.k.a. Michelin at Goodwood, a.k.a. Moderate Misfit Podcast.
Man, to his left, man, Big D-Lo Money.
Yo, man, Big D-Lo Money, man, the real D-Lo Money, you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Behind him, man, Big Lonnie Bands.
That's me.
And we got...
It's the thuggish, ruggish bone. It's the thuggish, ruggish bone.
My bad.
I was going to say something, but it ain't good for TV. So we're going to let it
say it's
he was going to call her slut.
Nah, damn. I was about to say bone thugs and sluttery.
At least you're not the
bone thugs and sluttery. Hey.
No, y'all been coming with the slut, with the slut, with the slut pun is crazy.
Yeah,
hey, that Schlutterbahn shit.
Schlutterbahn is funny.
That Schlutterbahn shit is crazy.
That was top tier.
Hey, bro. Like, indoor plumbing.
Hey, you know I'm a slut at heart, so you know.
Man, I know the fuck I am, man. Angelo Corleone, we back in this motherfucker once again, man. Talking good shit, man. I'm not drinking with Tego no more, man. I swear to God, I'm not, bro.
Hey, man.
I moved your hair with my.
She put her fucking fingers on your shoulders.
Hey, you gotta move your. Hey, bro, you're
type shit.
Yeah.
But,
go to timeout. Go to timeout.
Time out 5 minutes. You gotta go.
Time out.
This is crazy. I brought y'all food.
30 seconds.
Time out. In like
A minute.
You gotta talk to Cuz.
Missionary with the toes in the mouth is crazy.
Go crazy.
So, listen, y'all. So, and then he wonder why.
We was talking about some other shit, man.
Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead.
Stop shooting out the car, bro. What you doing?
We got the Uzis hanging out.
Oh, God.
Hey. We was talking about Lena cousin, partner.
If we being for real, man, for real, for real. We was talking about the first time y'all started licking ass, man. But you got to get off that.
Long, long time ago, man. Them was the days, though.
Back in my day.
Yeah. Back in your heyday. We got to get off
that.
Leave that alone, man. What I was really asking y'all is, y'all feel like Gucci the worst CEO ever?
Yes, I do.
For definitely. Real?
Yes.
Because all the people
got
died.
No leadership skills, bro.
Is it because the people that got, you know?
Nah, it's just like.
But think right. about the original 1017.
Oh, some real shit. Look at Gucci. Mm. And then look at Gotti.
Okay.
You feel me? All Gotti artists is living good and being them, you feel me?
Type shit.
Like, even Mozzie. Mozzie did his stint, but that was before he signed, you know? He had some other shit that Gotti helped him out with. Nigga, all Gucci shit dying and going to jail, bro. Yeah. Rest in peace to them people, though.
What's her name?
Enchantin.
Yeah.
Pinpoint. I didn't know that was her that said, Sue, woo, it's just me, my bloods, and I.
That's her?
Yes.
Damn, R.I.P., that's fucked up. I didn't know she, yeah.
That was her.
What that song?
Yeah.
It's fucked up. What Pooh Shiesty now?
Huh?
Pooh Shiesty?
In jail? In jail. He doing like 8.
Yeah.
Shit. Who else signed to that nigga?
Big Score G. Dead.
Damn.
Hot Boy Wish.
Somebody in jail. Somebody got. Yeah. Somebody lost their contract.
This some Illuminati
Asian guy was signed to him, wasn't she?
Nah. K Sade was signed to him. She got out of her deal. That Road Boy nigga got out of his deal.
He just not a nigga that you want to go fucking with.
I feel like
that nigga's a black cat. Bad luck.
I feel like he signed niggas for a certain reason
to kill him.
So
insurance money.
Crazy.
Basically, this fucking point. Kid.
That's all a contract is. I don't know if y'all pay attention to this shit.
300.
They go get a motherfucker that ain't got no following. Nobody knows about him. Like, for example, Meek Mill. This nigga went and pulled Lil Snoop out the dirt. He put him up there, had him hot.
Yeah, valid. That's valid.
He was a nobody. He had no following. Like, niggas just ain't going to sign
anybody type shit. For no fucking reason. Yeah, it's some shit behind that, man. Like that 300 shit.
It's a sign. I ain't saying, you know, man, fuck niggas, but that shit wasn't right to me.
Yeah. RP them niggas,
nah,
man.
Like, I just feel like you, with the type of niggas he go sign, bro, you gotta make sure you keep them niggas out them situations, bro. But it's
certain niggas like you just can't do something for. Like Big Scar, I feel like that was just some
nigga. Like, I mean, you could have told the nigga to slow down on the perks, but then like,
oh yeah, all it takes is one bad pill.
Yeah, like, and that's but, the thing. Yeah, like,
no, bro, I ain't gonna say, like, bro, you know, I ain't gonna say, but some of that shit just don't be promising. Life is life. Everything happened. You feel me? Yeah. But you never know what a motherfucker going through. But they called him the Grim Reaper. You feel me?
Yeah.
They called him the Grim Reaper. So he was probably trying to cope with some shit that he done did. You feel me? So, yeah, but that shit, bro, I don't know. He's not good. He's not, he ain't got no leadership.
And then as far as like the Pooh Shiesty, you know, Fujiano situations, like, bro, why do you have an artist in Miami buying shit from some random niggas and getting in shootouts? Then proceeding to go to a club, drop some money on the floor, and then let his gun go off.
I mean, that ain't nothing. I don't think that's nothing that he.
But
can.
I'm saying, like, bro, it's a way, bro.
You supposed to instill in your artist a way to move.
Like, nigga, yeah, like, nigga, like,
niggas,
bro,
you should.
In my
like
eyes, bro, if
way
you
too much fucking money.
If you the money man, bro, you probably shouldn't have no pole money.
But like, that's the thing, though. The thing is, if them niggas was eating, them niggas wouldn't have to do street shit. You feel me? Yeah, they got some bread.
I agree with you, but I gotta disagree with you in a way. Just because I feel like niggas, it's hard for niggas to leave their life alone to an extent.
If I'm up, I'm up. I'm gonna always be who I am.
Yeah.
But it's other people around me that'll do shit that they don't want me to do. You dig what I'm saying?
But see, that's
like, not even on no little bro shit, just like.
But that's a thing, like, you got a different situation. You got to think, these are some young niggas. I think the only nigga that's close to age with us was Fujiano. I think he probably around, our age. Pooh, like, what, 22,
23? Nah, I thought he was older than that.
Nah,
Pooh. He's young like that?
Yeah. These niggas is young, bro. So, like, they still,
Like, they still hot. Like, nigga, they still in the streets. Like, we was just talking about, like, the Big 30 shit. Like, nigga, these niggas still in the streets for niggas that's dying down.
Yeah.
So, like, it is.
But then again, that's going back to saying he don't got good leadership skills.
Yeah.
That's just me. Because, like, I tell my young niggas some real shit. Like, you'll have to, like, in the sense of, like, bro, you don't. It's just like changing the youth. What you taking out the hood for if you still gonna just let them do hood shit?
But it's up to them to listen, though.
It is, but come on, bro. If you somebody to look up to, bro.
But do you feel like he, do you feel like looking from the outside looking in, do you think he did get that word of wisdom? Mm. Respect. And I can, and
like, I mean, necessarily, I don't. Because, like, me personally, I wouldn't assign the Gucci fresh out the feds, bro. You still got to get you some motion.
He had motion at the time. Can't say that.
When he came home?
Yeah.
Nah.
Who?
Gucci.
Nah. Gucci had motion? Did some shit? Drake and some motion?
Nah.
I don't know why Gucci did come
he
out.
He had some shit because it's Gucci, though.
Yeah.
But, like, nigga, that shit didn't last long. Like, for real, though, it's like, for example, E-40 and Open B-Peasy. You feel me? Me personally, I don't want to go sign to somebody that signed to somebody. Dig what I'm saying? Because it's like, you trying to make it. You feel me? You trying to make it. And, well, you made it. But you still trying to, you know, make a way for yourself on top of trying to, like, help us out. But you would take the bigger opportunity and give us a smaller opportunity, being an artist. You know? Because you're an artist still.
It's the whole reason why Mimo 600 left OTF.
Yeah. Like, I want to be signed to a mogul. I don't want to be signed to nobody that got a label deal.
Or about their own business type shit.
I want a motherfucker that got their own shit. I signed to somebody that got their own shit. Like, niggas that bought themselves out their deal, and now they started their own shit. Oh, because it. Now you looking out for my best interest because you want me to win. You feel me? He was still signed to somebody.
Here telling no. You what the fuck to do type shit.
Right. He was still signed to somebody when he came home. You feel me? It wasn't just 10-17. He had a deal with somebody else. You feel me? And that's when shit get tricky.
One nigga signed to another nigga that signed to another nigga.
Yeah, you don't sign to a nigga that signed to a nigga.
That signed to a label.
You feel me?
Yeah. It's a whole lot of politics.
That's most likely has a parent label.
But, like, for example, 42 Doug. I feel like 42 Doug is in the worst time of shit
mama.
In my life.
Because
he signed to two labels.
Yeah.
So you got to produce with two labels. And then it's like, baby didn't want to just give him the Gotti. He like, nigga, hey, we're going to have to do something. Because if he going to be something... I found it first, but you can find, like, that's the thing a nigga don't know. In the industry, they got finder fees. You feel me? Like, A&Rs get finder fees.
Yeah. Trippie Red got one for 6ix9ine.
Yeah, it's a finder's fee. So it's like, I got somebody, but if you want to get with him, come holler at me.
Truth be told, that's why that show is trippy between Lil Baby and Youngboy and them. Because of No Cap.
Yeah.
Because Baby found No Cap. No Cap wasn't getting paid with Baby because Baby didn't know how to do the shit. And then No Cap went and signed with Youngboy and them.
What I respect about Baby on that behalf, though, he ain't really feed into that shit.
Yeah, but fact.
I think he fucked one of these bitches.
It's always about a bitch, ain't
it? I think he fucked one of Youngboy's bitches, though, because he said something in the song. But he don't entertain that shit.
No, I think he fucked No Cap bitch or something. Cause,
when he said he fucked that rap, I did, yeah.
Yeah, because that rap nigga bitch. Like, I mean, No Cap was really, like, going at it in songs, low-key, like, but, like, the wordplay them niggas be putting on just so crazy.
But thing is, like, you'll have to know, yeah. Man, like, that local rap shit, because they locals in they city.
Type shit.
Like, in Atlanta, they're somebody, like, they're famous, but they're locals. You feel me? They grew up around this motherfucker, so... Like, even with the YSL and the Lucci shit.
It's all the politics with the shit.
Oh, that shit. You did
like, that shit's crazy to me.
But
like,
they still sitting around that motherfucker. They know what's going on in their city.
That nigga Woody been cracking me up the whole YSL trial. I'm not going to lie to you, bro.
Yeah,
that is the funniest nigga alive, bro.
Was that the
why
nigga
you did my shows?
She said, you said, yeah. He He said, yeah. I said, yeah, because you kept on asking me questions.
He said, if you ask me what color this, like, what color your shoes is? She, they Chucks. Oh, fucking wow, bro.
Man, let's leave this political shit alone. I'm bad, y'all. Sorry, I got a lot of real political. I guess I had some questions about the Gucci shit because I seen Enchanta. What's her name?
Enchanting. Nah, but I feel like just to end this situation, I feel like in her situation, bro, that was some crash out of that shit. I'm sorry. Because, bro, you just seen somebody you was close to die the same way.
Best friend.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, you just seen this man go out the same way, and you turn around and do the same thing. So, we, yeah.
R.I.P. her, man. Fuck it.
Nah, real life.
Lonnie, what's the, Lonnie, Bone, what's the oldest man you ever dated?
The oldest?
Oldest man.
Be real.
Dated? Like, we was together?
Y'all was together.
We know it was hunk.
My cup.
57.
He was not 57. Oh, he was
45. 38.
45?
Mm-hmm. Bone? 57. 53.
Totally. What if a nigga was 72? Ooh, yeah. What
can I do with him? Hit me up. I mean,
this the oldest nigga that y'all been with?
Yeah.
Are you going somewhere with this?
Yeah, Bill Belichick was dating 24.
24? Crazy, bro.
Same shit.
She was 24.
Or how was you?
Who?
You.
What you mean?
I'm so confused.
What's the oldest shit I done dated?
Yeah.
The oldest? I mean. Yeah.
Yeah, I feel like y'all was gold digging in like some type of situation.
No, I wasn't gold digging. It just get crazy.
No, I don't feel like I was gold digging either.
I can't really get into it. Yeah.
Why not date somebody your age? Why? What is y'all feelings about old person? I mean, the older person does for y'all, the younger person don't do for y'all.
Ain't necessarily that.
I don't like people my age.
Why?
I need experience. A different mindset. A lot of these niggas my age are childish. Did y'all? I'm only 23.
That's too vague.
Man, talk to me.
That's too vague. What are old niggas giving you that old young nigga can't give you? Type shit.
A father figure.
I have a father. Me and my dad are pretty darn close. I love him.
That, like, retirement fund.
No, my dad not that old. My dad is only like, you know, what, 45.
That's what an old nigga can give you that these young niggas can't.
It just depends on how old you get. But you out here fucking with wheelchair music. You just off the chain. Yeah. Right?
Okay, so let me ask y'all a question because I watched this movie today on Amazon, and y'all know how men, they date younger women all the time. As long as they're legal and nobody ever really say anything, everybody just let it slide. No, so, but why is it so bad?
They definitely do. They say a lot.
What they be saying?
You'll get a label for doing some shit like that. And it just be like on accident that you was fucking with this person and they'll call you every name in the book and you wasn't even the one that shot the shot. You feel me? Like real shit. Right. On some gangster shit. Like, it just happens like that. But yes, no. Niggas definitely talk about you. You would definitely get a label if.
So what's too young? Like, what's too big of an age gap?
I know a 5-year difference was a big thing.
5-year difference?
5-year difference.
Yeah, 5-year difference was a big thing. But it's motherfuckers out here that it exceeded the limit. You feel me?
10 years, 15 plus type shit. No,
like, not real shit. And the shit was,
I feel like it depends on the age.
It depends on, it really is, it depends on who you are.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But, and I'm only 25. So I can't go no lower than that.
Like, yeah.
Yeah.
I can't go lower than I feel that. I can't. 21 is my, like.
That's pushing it, for real.
Yeah.
Bro. But, like, what do I look like dating somebody that's a teenager, bro? That's dead.
How much do y'all really have in common type? Yeah, all those kind of conversations come into play type shit. What you about to say, Lonnie?
I was just finna say that you could have a lot in common with somebody even though there's like a big age gap. Bro, teens, like,
is crazy.
I'm not
pushing it.
No, not teens. I honestly feel like women from the age of 18 to 25 really shouldn't even be messing with nobody because you too moldable. Like, you too, like, you still learning to be a woman.
That's just if a nigga got a manipulative spirit, manipulative.
But a lot of people don't know how to just come into your life and watch you grow and blossom into the woman that you're supposed to be without in some way trying to mold you to be the woman that they want you to be.
No, check it. Me and my baby mama got a 3-year difference, right? A lot of the shit that she wanted to do, I already did. So it's just like.
And that's how it be. Like, that be the thing.
All right, me and my shorty now, we got a 5-piece. Mm-hmm. You feel me? So, but she got an old spirit. So, like, she don't care to leave the house and just shake ass and be naked and shit. Mm. So, it's not a conflict of interest. You feel me? But a lot of these motherfuckers jump out here in this field, bro, and want to go deal with an older nigga, but don't want to deal with the shit that an older nigga, like, don't want to deal with. You feel me?
Yeah, like, they just think he going to provide for them and like that and be, you know.
They motherfucking like daddy.
What is providing for a woman?
Just spoil them and shit like that, but they don't understand, like, a good 9 out of 10, that nigga going to be strict as fuck. He ain't going to be going for none of that.
That fool-ass shit, unless the nigga got a childish mentality. Like, if you got a nigga that still want to, like, it's old niggas out here fucking with young bitches because they don't want to give it up and believe the fact that they fucking 55. Mm-hmm.
And that's, and you got them, that's the flip side of the coin.
You feel me? You still got niggas that want to still be young. Like, a nigga be 55 coming here in a Jordan jumpsuit. Yeah, swag on, you feel me? Swag on, you do what I'm saying? Do your thing, but you go trying to go fuck with a young bitch to see if you still got it and still be trying to run around this motherfucker. Being old, nigga, go put your Ben Gay on and put your robe on and go lay down.
Put your Ben Gay on, it's crazy.
Real shit,
bro. Lottie, what do you feel as if a younger woman has in common with an older man?
It just depends on the person. Like Tego said, like he said, his woman has an old soul. Like, some people have, you know, like, they've been through more experience at younger ages and stuff. So it's like, it just depends. It just really depends.
You were saying something earlier about providing for a woman. What do you feel like?
Yeah, I'm asking, what does, like, he, like, saying, y'all be wanting an older man to just provide for you. So I'm like, what is provide for you?
Like, you take some stress off your motherfucking back for some shit that you can't afford.
Okay. But why is it that she can't afford it?
Because the bitch broke, dog.
So why is she even wanting to be in a relationship?
To get these fucking get bills support. To care.
That's not love.
It's never love, bro. 9 times out of 10, that's the only time, like, a woman want even to be in a relationship anyway.
Because
when
they can't.
When the bitch is having paid, bro, the last thing her mind is a nigga, bro.
That's not true.
That's not true. That's not always true, but most of the time, that shit's true.
In all situations, it's not true.
Most of the time, that shit's true.
But, like, a lot of the times, these bitches be down bad on their ass. Broke down to their elbows and their brake pads and don't be having shit going on and want somebody to fucking save them. You feel me?
Which is, like, unfair.
But here's the question.
But on the flip side, you do got bitches that be with having that
money
pay,
and what just want a companion.
And then they be taking care of niggas.
But if them bitches, I don't respect them bitches either, because they want a son.
Y'all know how
they be controlling and all that.
They want a son. That's what I'm saying. I never let it just, like, if I, listen. I just want you to know I'm having my way. Right. If you want me to have this, go on, cool. Get it for me. But I just want you to know you will never be able to burn me because I'll break this shit.
Oh, wait.
You won't give a fuck.
Like, I would slam this shit. God. Yes, I would slam this shit on the ground.
Oh, God.
Like, for real.
Oh, you mean, like, they buy you stuff just to, like, say they did that?
Like, thin line between love and hate.
Wait, what about thin line between love and hate?
The bitch.
She on the bitch side.
No, I don't give a fuck what side the bitch on. I mean, you know what I mean? What I'm saying is, like, he did some foul shit. I mean, he was being a nigga. You know what I mean? He was trying to fuck. But she told the nigga. You know, he knew the bitch was crazy. Mm-hmm. What I'm saying is, she did all of this and all of that, trying to control the nigga, trying to change the nigga image, trying to make him not be him. Mm-hmm. You feel me? And it's because she had money on it. You feel me? She wouldn't let the nigga be him and still spend that spread. You feel me? She wanted to break a nigga down to his brake pad shit out in front of the police station. Yeah. Because he like, fuck it.
You know? But I mean, do you feel as if it's some type of, like, I don't know, not conforming, like, conforming in a relationship, but, like, I don't know.
I feel like you gotta
do some
that,
shit.
You got females that want a dependent.
Mm-hmm. And a companion. And
you got bitches that want to be dependent. Like, bitches say they want to be, you know, stand on their own. And
the bitches that want a dependent need to go have some fucking kids.
But shit, they got to get the nigga first to have a kid.
Right. But, like, don't treat a grown-ass man like a little-ass boy just because you spending some money.
But then you can't even blame him because it be niggas out here allowing that shit. Like, nigga,
they
sitting up here at the crib playing PS5 all day. You ain't got up off your ass, showered.
Them the worst type of niggas, though. Like, them niggas deserve to be treated like a fucking child. Because, like, there's no way as a grown man you do not want to get up and make no money. Mm-hmm. Ain't nobody saying go get a job, but we all got the same 24. I guarantee you, if you do the right thing, you can make some money.
On me.
It's all type of hustles.
It's all type of hustles. I wish I had a bitch that boy had some paper and let me shit at the crib.
You know how much money you can make off a fucking lawnmower?
Bro, do you hear me?
I'd be so fucking up. Boy, I'd probably be streaming in that bitch or something if
no. I was. I swear to God, nigga, my baby mama told me at one point. People like, bro, quit that job. I just need to make more money in a day, bro.
Get that shit together. Why do women date older men?
But that was the worst advice a bitch could give. That was the worst advice. Not real shit.
You know me, though.
I made some bread, but it was just like a lot of dead time and street running.
Yeah.
You feel me?
For nothing.
Real shit. It's a lot of dead time and street running.
Shay date a lot of older niggas. Talk to me, bro.
Why the fuck? Didn't I just say don't do that?
No, you love the old niggas, man.
I feel like, I don't know, I feel like older niggas kind of got their shit together more. That's I'm so for real. From the older niggas that I've experienced, they got their shit together different than the younger niggas.
What's that mean?
Like, I don't know. They out of they having hoes ways. Some of them older niggas, you know, they really be on that.
Y'all believe that?
Y'all believe that?
No.
Can I ask you something?
I said some of them, huh?
So, being an entrepreneur, right?
Right.
A woman of her own. Would you deal with a nigga that ain't got shit?
No.
How come?
Because I come with shit, so you gotta come with shit.
I mean, I can respect that, so but like, what if he's like...
He trying to
get... The older nigga...
No. What if he's genuine to you, though? Like...
That's fine. That's dandy. I don't think I would be able to take you serious, because at some point, I'm gonna have them expectations like, okay, I'm doing this, this... Mm-hmm. Like, I know what I'm able to bring to the table. I know what I'm able to provide. So at this point, what can you provide for me besides that genuinity?
So you don't believe in building a nigga?
We're grown as fuck.
Respect. I'm not about to build no nigga. It just be, no, but it be shit.
You can't. I'm not going to build a nigga, no.
That's shit, though, but like.
It took me 27 years to build myself, and I'm damn near, I'm not even built like I want to be. So I'm not about to sit there and take time out of putting into myself to put into a grown-ass man that should have been putting into himself from the beginning.
I can respect that. I can respect that. I was just asking, because it's women out here that just dead-ass want a dependent. You feel me? Like a nigga that they can mold.
If I wanted a dependent, I would have a child nigga, before I took on a nigga, I'm not gonna lie.
Younger bitch, if an old nigga take a younger bitch and mold him, mold her into what he want her to be, bitches do the same thing. They take a broke ass nigga and mold him into a fucking son. And
then when so then as soon as they break up, she gonna be like, nigga, I made you who you are. Like,
no, that's how it goes, though. Because, like, y'all ain't never seen the bitch that went and got that hobo cleaned him up and now that nigga getting money on.
Oh, yeah, I'm talking about, yeah.
That type of shit happens, bro.
She made it to a princess motion, though.
But, bitch, you just down bad desperate.
I mean,
go get a nigga.
I feel like Shasha said all that. So, like, what's the difference between, like,
that nigga had flies flying around his ass. All right, my bad. That's love. Bro. That's love and desperate
shit. I think she did that for other people's gratification.
But she did it, though.
Yeah. I think she did.
That nigga winning.
He modeled some emotion, though.
Yeah.
Like married that to a princess. Winning. He up.
Yeah.
Not her?
No, you never left her.
Yeah, but you so dirty.
No, that bitch would know, because, like, I swear to God, if I'm fucked up, you feel me, and you get me right, yeah, I got a different type of respect for you. But, bitch, once you start trying to talk to me like I ain't shit, and I'm the shit now, I wasn't the shit then, bitch. I wasn't the shit then, bitch. I'm the shit now.
Bitch,
and you still talking to me like I'm a hobo? Bitch, watch me take this new swag to this new bitch and watch how she love me.
Bro, this ain't last year.
Bro, shit, you hear me?
This ain't last year.
Bitch, this ain't love don't cost a thing, bitch. I'm not Alvin, I'm Al, bitch.
Expect me as such. What are you talking about?
Yeah.
I'm telling you, bitch, I wasn't broke. I was fucked up.
I wasn't broke. I was fucked up. But now, like, Shay Shay gets basically said all that, and, like, I don't know. I feel like, what's the difference between you saying that and then going to date the old nigga? You want the old nigga to basically, like, pay for your life.
No, it's the my life is already paid for. I do that shit on my own, so I feel like an old, like, dating with, fucking with somebody older, I expect you
to come with
something. You don't have to pay for my life. Like, I feel like if you know, I ain't even gonna speak for myself, but if you know a bitch is materialistic, why would you approach that bitch with no materials?
I hate a materialistic bitch.
Like, you.
I do not like a materialistic bitch.
But you know the thing about the material bitches, bro?
What?
They don't be doing that shit for themselves.
No, bitch, you have no materials.
Like, my thing is, bro, don't be a materialistic bitch.
Why are you worried about my
materials? I just feel like you can't be materialistic if you don't have materials.
Real shit, though.
Check me out. You can't expect a nigga to... And I think I told Lonnie this. I said, bro,
niggas know what they doing. Like, bitches want to compare niggas to dogs all the time. Dogs is smart, bro.
No, but them bitches is more like dogs than us.
Bitches.
Yeah. Y'all.
Okay.
Y'all.
Okay.
Now get fucked, get pregnant, and reproduce and have puppies. Like, bitch, you are a mutt. Like, really.
Fuck.
My bad. Go ahead.
So, like, a nigga gonna feel like he can do what he can do to you because of how you carry yourself. Like, straight up. So, if you feel like you a bitch that want bags and shit, bitch, you gotta have bags on you. Like, bitch. Come in this
motherfucker. How long?
At least 2 minutes, bro.
Where I go?
Just a minute, bro. You
got it. Y'all got it.
That nigga, it's called.
He said, bitch, you are a mutt.
He got 2 minutes of time outside, bro. What's cuz on, bro?
Nah, but.
That nigga started wilding, bro. Stop shooting out the car and saying, oh, what you doing?
Hey, dude, well, bro.
Man, what's wrong with you niggas?
Don't say you're my nigga. That did hurt, bro. That's nothing but all bone, bro.
Oh, yeah. And another thing about older, like, to piggyback off what she was saying was, like, not just because they be having, like, less holes and shit. Like, they become more, like, more structure. Like, just better advice and just some shit that, like, they've been through.
Just a little bit more.
Just a little bit.
So you get married. So you get married to an older nigga, right? So you get married or whatever like that. And, like, you know, y'all relationship is, you know, for wishes or whatever like that. Or whatever fucking word is. Shit lasts for a little bit. And end up cheating on you.
Uh-huh.
Do you expect half?
Do I expect half of what?
His money.
Yeah.
Why?
Because I feel like once we at a certain point in our marriage, we start putting that shit in together. It's not just his.
Joint bank.
But if he got at least, like, say you got $1 million coming in.
Mm-hmm.
And you got 20,000 coming in. You feel as if your 20,000 is equal to that million?
I feel like as a man, you should do what you know is best.
Yeah, bitch, not give me money.
You should put yourself in a position to fumble your million. Like, why would you even put yourself in a position to do something like that? Like, we're in love. Like, we've been loving each other for years. We've been married.
No, you're
in
love.
You see him.
No good relationship ended because of cheating.
Hey, look, I'm going to tell you right now.
I wouldn't. I can only speak for me. I'm saying, like, I wouldn't. My nigga, you ain't just finna be cheating.
No,
but if my man was to cheat, I'm not gonna be like, all right, relationship over.
Yeah.
No, I'm saying, like, no good relationship ended because of cheating. It's because it led up to that point. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I got you.
Some type of unhappiness if y'all was happy at some point. Nigga ended up going out and cheating, whatever the fuck.
I'm gonna tell you.
Wait, so you saying that niggas gotta be unhappy to cheat?
I'm not saying
because that's not true.
That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying that no good relationship ended because of cheating.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
A nigga be vibrating at the highest level and still go. You did what I'm saying.
You said nigga what?
On me, because I love the shit out of bitch and just want to go crack something down.
Yeah.
You did what I'm saying. I need some of that.
What's wrong with you, nigga?
But, what's wrong with you, nigga?
So what if you and your husband was getting a divorce, right?
Uh-huh.
And like he had hella cash put up, like you would.
Was I aware of it?
I mean, of course. You do what I'm saying?
That.
You have all some of it. You have all half of his cash.
All of it. Give it here.
See, I'm going to tell you right now.
It definitely depends on what role I play.
So what if I'm, okay, say what if it was vice versa? Y'all divorced and the nigga wanted some money from you.
That's what I'm saying.
Then if I started the relationship with money, I expect some sort of money. If he started with some money, he should expect some sort of money.
Y'all some acrimony type shit.
So you would pay the nigga? Half?
I would be sad.
It genuinely depends on the terms and the
end. Fuck all that. No, Shay. I don't want to hear that shit.
Definitely terms and conditions.
If we ended on mutual terms and we both like, okay, we know this shit ain't working, we gonna go ahead and stop. And yeah, you get half, I get half. We go our separate ways. Boom. You do what you do, I do what I do.
Yeah.
If we ended on some domestic shit, or we into it and it's like
spousal. Oh, bitch, you ain't getting a thing.
Bitch, you're not getting a dime.
You don't break down half of your million for a nigga that 20,000? Yeah, go ahead.
I'm saying we've had years in, like we're in love, like we not in love now, but whatever shit happened, I'm not just gonna let you fall out on your ass.
Oh, you had 20,000.
Like,
okay, so let me ask you.
Oh God, y'all better than me. What the fuck are we talking about right now?
Let me ask you something. So you said
why are we selfish? I made this money.
Like I love
y'all. Know I'm genuinely not a selfish person. So
in that
instance, I wouldn't be selfish.
I'm not saying leave empty handed.
Especially like no, you can like especially if I'm the one in a better position. You can have a house. My nigga, like, I'm out of here. Like,
if you piss me off, we can
Yeah.
Come back.
Can I come back, please? Nah, but bro, it's 2024, bro. You better get you a CPN and put some money up.
Oh my God. I keep telling niggas, bro. They think I ain't gonna get into that on camera.
Mm-mm, that ain't for the camera.
Oh God, that ain't for the camera.
My bad. I spilled too much sauce.
Way too much sauce.
What fucking sauce? Spill your sauce.
CPN mean carpal tunnel nuggets.
Yeah.
That don't even.
They take it out your fingers.
That would be
CTN.
Go off though.
Carpal.
Go off.
This is PN carpal tunnel. What's wrong with you?
He just got
there.
I'm like, when did
you?
You gonna be? You
got
to go back to the seat.
Man, this sent me to detention. I
gotta
go.
Home.
ISS.
ISS is crazy. Damn.
That's ISS food.
Give him Roy. Ain't that the rest of the year?
Yeah, leave that nigga alone, Roy. Man. Nah.
We had a long time to go in a year.
Damn. Hey, I feel like $1 million is enough to change your life.
No.
Hell
yeah. Yeah.
Fuck no. Yeah. No, it'll change it, but it ain't gonna. Yeah. It ain't gonna last.
But shit. This is the thing: if you financially responsible and or a hustler,
$1 million puts you in position.
Exactly, that shit gonna change your life, bro. Of course, it's not enough to live off of. But he didn't ask that.
You can.
He said, "Is it gonna change your life?"
Yes,
it's gonna change your life.
I feel like a meal is enough for you to fuck off and still
do something. But that's what
a lot of niggas was reaching for, like trying to get deals. They was just reaching for $1 million. That's the only thing a nigga reach for. They're not coming with an M.
But the thing is, like, if, like I say, if you're financially responsible and or a hustler, bro, you gonna be Gucci off of that shit.
Oh, but him, yeah, you gonna be straight. You gonna be straight.
What can you see yourself doing with a meal?
With a meal?
Yeah.
Being boozy. I'm gonna be the boosiest nigga. I'm gonna be the boosiest nigga you ever seen.
Boy, I be playing.
I'm gonna do a lot of different shit with that shit. You hear me?
I'm gonna invest. And I'm gonna put my meds on. But the thing is,
stocks and bonds and cryptocurrency.
Nah, cryptocurrency is crazy. And I have one of my close brothers gonna teach me the sauce. You feel me? Yes, he's gonna teach, huh?
You gonna teach me?
And shit, once he teach me, because that nigga is crazy with that shit. But what I'm saying is, a meal, what I do with a meal, I'm gonna get me a Lamborghini motor scooter or something.
Lamborghini motor scooter.
I feel like if niggas touch money like that, they would genuinely buy the dumbest shit they could think of.
I would.
Y'all would go straight for the dumb shit.
I feel like
the stupid shit. The cars and the clothes.
There's going to be a statue of me. I feel like my mama's yard.
I feel like if
see the dumb shit. Like,
hold up, on some real shit. I feel like if you was to give a man $1 million and a woman $1 million on the same day, I feel like the woman to go broke first. I ain't gonna lie.
That is that's not. Why do you feel like?
The match with that one.
You know what I'm saying? A bitch will be able to fuck that shit off, cool. But no. A bitch is gonna go and she's gonna open up a fucking teeth. She's gonna go buy some bundles and open up his hair shop.
I can fully subscribe to that. No. But it just depends on what type of female you give it to. How old is she? Sure.
Bitches be having too much on their mind.
29.
Bitches like, is gonna go open. They gonna go open up a that boutique. They gonna go open
29,
up a shoe.
29, 30.
She's broke.
She's gonna open up a boutique. She's gonna open up a shoe store. She's gonna open up.
Talking about you.
I was literally about to say. I was literally about to say you might do that.
I don't know how many bitches be wanting to do that. Okay.
29 to 30. She's broke.
My God.
29 to 30. 29 to 30, she's going broke.
She's going broke as fuck.
That bitch gonna buy so much Don Julio, her piss gonna stink.
She might own a share in Don Julio.
No, for real though.
She gonna give all her friends each 100 bands.
Yeah, and she's gonna go broke.
Damn.
And that bitch gonna buy. She gonna buy that dependent ass nigga Trackhawk.
Oh yeah.
You think she gonna start buying her niggas?
She gonna buy 10 P's, he gonna fall off by the end.
She gonna give him 10 P's, 250 bands, some jewelry, you do what I'm saying.
And he's still gonna go cheap.
You give a nigga a nigga that ain't never had shit, a nigga that ain't got shit. Let's say that. Like a bum ass nigga. A bum ass nigga that really came from the mud. You give him that same million, he's gonna be determined to never go broke again.
And I feel like that's 100%.
Because, like,
not every nigga, though.
It depends because some niggas be too deep into their trenches and they become a product of their environment and they're going to take that shit and fuck that shit and blow it. Niggas will blow that shit. I'm not going to hold you. I know a nigga on Facebook right now. He was just up some money and I ain't seen this nigga do not one thing productive besides go get a watch, some goals, go get his motherfucking hair done, go get some shoes. I ain't seen that nigga do not one thing productive.
But next week I might pull up.
And he be on live every day with nothing but peas and Don Julio. And that's a nigga, not a bitch.
I know, I ain't gonna lie, I know a nigga that came up.
What is he doing?
I don't know what the nigga doing.
Niggas that ain't never had no money. Yeah. How? Definitely no ain't never really had no real bitches.
Because okay. I do know some niggas. I have seen some niggas come up on some pape and just.
And no. You literally watch them on Facebook Live, fag that shit off on bottles. And
but what I'm saying is, I see this more amongst women. I've seen females come across the same amount of pape that I've seen the same nigga come across.
Yes.
And like that shit just poof, like was gone. Nothing to show for it. And it's just coming out of her mouth.
I guess I'm just speaking from my circle. Because from the women I see that come up on pape, them bitches got their boutiques. They got their bundles and their wigs on hand. They got their shoe stores open. They got their little, like, I see bitches on their shit. I ain't seen no bitch really touch no real pape and fuck that shit off. I'm not going to hold you.
That bitch probably ain't told you she touched no pape.
I said I ain't seen. I'm speaking for, I guess, what I see in my circle.
I'm speaking for me.
Yeah, because I'm only speaking for what I've seen. You do what I'm saying. And I've seen, you know, I know a lot of financially responsible motherfuckers, male and female. Mm-hmm. But just for the sake of conversation, I be feeling like women tend to blow that shit more. But I've seen niggas.
I'm not
a lot of niggas.
Responsible.
Nigga. You deal with what I'm saying? Blow that shit.
Well, I'm not. Bro, if I want it, I got to have it. I don't give a fuck.
I feel that.
Like, no, I really, like, because it's like. Like, you remember that old saying, like, money burn a hole in your pocket? Mm. You feel me? Mm-hmm. Like, nigga, I had a lot of money. That shit was just misspent. Like, I swear to God, like, nigga, I had some money, you know, like. Scheme after scheme after scheme, like.
Type shit.
Before I got locked up, I had some chicken. So it's like, but the thing is, like, I don't give a fuck. This shit gonna come back. You feel me? So
that's a toxic way of thinking,
it is,
bro.
No, it definitely is. And I'm grown enough to say that is a toxic way of thinking because, like, I don't give a fuck, bro, because I ain't, it's certain shit in life as a child that I wanted that I didn't have. So as an adult, nigga, I'm not gonna say no to myself.
For sure.
Because motherfucker said no to me.
I'm a firm believer in, like, you do gotta treat yourself sometimes. You know what I'm saying?
I treat myself
but,
all the time.
But, you know what I'm saying? Personally, I just be feeling like you gotta prioritize saving some money sometimes. Because you gonna need that shit sooner.
See, now I'm cool. Because, like, now I can spend some shit and still have some shit. But then, nigga, I don't give a fuck, nigga. If I want extra cheese on this Big Mac, bitch, I'm getting it.
Oh, God.
You feel me?
Extra cheese, please.
No, for real. If I want a large fry from Five Guys, I'm getting it.
I don't give a fuck. I'm not telling myself.
I be on that shit now. So these days, because, like.
Let's go to the crib. They got drinks?
Yeah. I can kind of. You deal with what I'm saying? Do that more these days.
Right,
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like when I was, you know what I'm saying? Like a couple years ago, I couldn't really be on it as much.
Yeah.
And so that's where my mindset come from as far as like trying to prioritize putting some money up. You did what I'm saying?
Right,
because
the realest thing, and Tez told me this. I swear to God, Tez told me this. He said, nigga, don't buy it if you can't buy it twice. Mm.
Do y'all feel like y'all have a good relationship with money?
I do.
Yeah, I love it.
What was our first, like, introduction to money?
To money?
Shit.
The Tooth Fairy?
The Tooth Fairy?
I mean, shit. My parents had money. You know what I'm saying? Like, my parents had money, so do that count?
Yeah, this might actually piggyback on why I like men giving me money. Because, like, my dad, I'm a daddy's girl, y'all. Like, my dad, every time I seen my dad, he was always, like, hustling. And he'll come back home. And every time he hugged me, he'll put $100 in my hand. I hate that. And then, like, I used to just get the $100 and be like, thanks, Dad. You know, put it in my piggy bank, whatever. And if I went somewhere and I came back, my dad would be like, baby girl, how much money you got? And if I'd be like, I only got $20, he'd be like, so what you spent 80 on? And if I couldn't tell him, like, every dollar that I spent, he wouldn't give me money for a while. So it gave me, like, to learn how to handle my money.
Right.
And then I could start giving his money.
I mean,
so do you feel like at that point, do you think your love could be bought?
No, my love can't be bought. But I definitely gotta have it. Like, I gotta have the money.
Shit, my love can't be bought.
No, because I give love to people freely all the time. Like,
that's
all
true.
The time. I give love freely.
I respect that.
You are such a dancer. You text me a check. Dancer,
you text me a check.
It was a good way of dancing, so I'm going to respect it.
My day, bro. Lighten my day up.
No, for real.
That was a good job, so I'm going to respect it.
You can't even pay
me to disrespect me. Like, because all money ain't good money. Like, I don't care about the money. But if you going to be in my mind,
I was about to go back to time out, bro.
My dad, listen, my dad don't even play like that. If I introduce a man to my dad, the first thing my dad gonna say is, contradiction. How are you providing? My dad gonna be like, how are you providing for her? What are you doing for her?
That ain't my job.
And that smells dad. Like contradiction in here, Lonnie, and I love you, but it.
He don't have to do anything for me.
I love you,
but don't stand in my way of doing for me. If you ain't gonna let me do for me,
y'all
then you do for me.
Contradiction smells like ass.
Type shit.
I just feel like I need to get out of here.
I'm just saying.
I just feel like
y'all
need to get out of here.
I'm not gonna lie to you.
I'm
drunk, so like.
No. I feel like y'all about to go down a rabbit hole that we don't need to really explore.
Somebody else. His family. I'm looking for a man that has a mindset like my dad.
Push
them
up their asses. I don't bullshit.
My dad never went out and hustled.
No.
And didn't put money to the side for his family.
I'm gonna start shooting at the car.
His mama, his sister, his girlfriend, his kids. He never went out, made money, and didn't give money to his people.
But you just said that's why you like getting money from others.
So like, we gonna eat tomorrow morning?
Why I like getting money. Yes, like, because if you love me and you out here making money, why
you share the fucking post?
Why you didn't put something?
Because when I work and I make money, I'm putting money to the side for my man. Like, oh yeah, I can't wait to get this to him. I don't care what he buy, what he spent. Like I told you, bought niggas games, all types of shit.
That sound like smudgy shit.
I'm just
saying. But I don't want to go back to time out.
So said, man.
I told y'all to get out of here.
I'm drunk, bro. It's like,
that's the truth.
Somebody else.
You just said, I can't wait to give my money to this nigga.
I'm saying some of it, not all of it, but like, I know, my dad.
So he get a percentage.
Not a percentage, but if you like love somebody and you work, percentage, like you making this much money and you got enough money to pay your bills, you doing all of this, but you can't put nothing to the side for this person. Like you can't go, oh, I make so much, let me put a couple $100 to the side for my man. That's too much to ask. Like, he don't gotta ask for this. I'm just giving this to you because I love you and I want to put some extra money in your pocket.
And you protect,
not because you like you asked me for it. I gotta do it. It's because I want to do it. Like,
and you protect me.
Yeah, like I want to do this for you.
He protect me.
Not like on no pimp shit. Like y'all thinking on some pimp.
No, ain't nobody saying that.
I'm saying I want to.
Of the word
because he said you protect me, right? Are you saying I'm paying for the protection?
Nah, that ain't what I said, bro. That ain't what I said.
Any nigga that
Bae, I love you, if I'm working for us,
he ain't never got to ask me for it because I'm not giving you an allowance, but know that I'm working for us.
Leave me alone, bro.
I'm gonna get you some of that.
Ask a question. Somebody else ask a question, please.
You want me to ask a question?
Please, somebody. Say something.
For 50,000.
Somebody touch about something. Boom.
Did y'all watch that movie on Netflix?
Which
one? No.
Tell Me You Love Me.
What's it about?
Tell them you love me.
What's it about?
It's about this disabled boy, right? And
oh, fuck.
Oh, never mind. Never mind.
Don't go there.
Not gonna do it.
Somebody else, Bone, ask a question, please.
Is it some more water? Is some more water? Thank you. I'm parched.
How was y'all day?
What y'all doing?
Bro, somebody please. Oh, dear God. What is that?
Hey, bro. I just want to say.
Oh, dear God.
Before we get too far gone, bro.
You're a gnat.
Make sure y'all check on y'all people's mental health, bro. Y'all never know what a motherfucker's going through, bro. And then you might not see them no more. Real shit. Just check on your people's mental health. Like, not even on no bullshit. Just check them. Ask me if they cool. And they say, yeah. But then be like, nigga, nah, but is you cool? Just make sure you ask your person, your people. Just check with their mental, bro.
So if they tell you they not boo, like, how you gonna go about it?
How I'm gonna go about it? I'm gonna ask them if they wanna talk about it. And like, nigga, if I got some advice, or some motherfuckers don't even want you to say shit back. Some motherfuckers just want you to listen to them.
Yeah.
Not real shit though.
But all right, cool.
And this is why I'm saying this, because I just recently lost one of my close relatives, you feel me? To suicide. You feel me? But going forward, you would never know that that's what this person was going to, because every time you see them, they got a smile on their face. You feel me?
Yeah.
Real shit. But me personally, yeah, if a motherfucker tell me, like, nah, I ain't all right. But the person that I am,
And I've been like this. Nigga, I make everybody problem my problems because so you won't go through that shit by yourself.
Amen.
Like, nigga, I call you every day, like, how you feeling? Nigga, I'm going to get on your nerves. Bitch, leave me alone. Let me grieve alone. I'm just trying to make sure you straight.
I feel you. But it's just certain problems. I ain't taking none.
Nah, some shit, but some motherfuckers, like...
Y'all can take like, on my example, car problems, bro, if y'all want to.
For example, like, I know it's certain niggas I can vent to.
Let me know.
You feel me? It's certain niggas I can genuinely vent to because they're going to be like... They're going to either tell me how they feel or they're just going to let me talk. You feel me? Because some shit is just be too much to keep bottled in. You feel me? Bottled up, should I say. Check on y'all people's mental health, but that's just...
All right. Stop tripping for this. Y'all woman or... checking on like her male like
yes.
friends and stuff.
Yes, yes. I have.
Yes,
bro. I have. I definitely have because why? No.
Her male
why friends, the fuck does friends? His mental health matter to you?
To you.
It is that simple.
That's wild.
It is that simple.
No, I really no. Since I've been
you my nigga.
No, fuck that. Since I've been out of jail, I had this argument and was ready to end that shit. No, it's not happening.
Nah,
hell no. It was funny shit before me.
It's gonna be some. It's gonna be some funny shit.
It's funny shit. It's funny.
It's funny shit, bro.
But I'm saying,
it's funny shit.
Because why do you care about another nigga mental health, bro?
Exactly, it's funny shit.
Why do you care about another? I swear to God, if that nigga die, you better not cry.
Different.
How is that different?
What? How is that different?
If they
your homegirl.
If dead ass,
we in the same friend circle.
Situation. If I know before. We got
into our funny
relationship.
Shit.
You was already, you know, vibing and cooling with these people.
I'm fucking nigga mental health.
I can't even get mad at that.
If that nigga ain't your relative, fuck that nigga.
But if this is a best friend type shit, fuck that nigga.
Same bitch, Shay Shay. Right? Shay Shay got a nigga, and the nigga don't know the pod like that or whatever. You know of us, but he don't know us. Like And Shay Shay hit us up.
But to know Shay Shay is to know she pod.
To know Shay Shay is to know that nigga better not say shit to me about none of that shit on this
phone. Good type shit, see somebody going to shit.
But that's it just depended on that.
How was that?
Hey. Because I feel like in certain situations, you got to tie certain people in the family. So a nigga been, if I been kicking it with this group of people for a minute, these is obviously my people. Like, these is my people.
How's any different word?
Nah, it's way different.
If she it's just with it's outside of the friend circle, nah. That's
if,
what it is.
If it's not a this group thing, all right. Nigga was around before you met her.
If this nigga, you and this nigga, because like a lot of these bitches be saying these niggas is they friends, but they used to have something.
Type shit.
The nigga done tried to grip.
Or he done grip.
No, it's a such thing as platonic relationships.
Definitely.
So if that's your platonic friend, like my mama has platonic friends, and my step pop's like... Even if they had a conversation, then my step pops asked, like, this nigga ever crack or he tried to crack? And you know what I mean? But just on some gang shit. But like, a platonic relationship is a real thing. Really? Dig what I'm saying? Your ribs all right over there?
Oh, my mama almost died.
But like, look. But like, if I know for a fact, if I know, y'all crazy as a motherfucker. If I know for a fact you and this nigga had something before me, oh, that's an ex, for real.
I'm gonna keep it a band. I don't care if y'all did or didn't, bro. I don't care if y'all did or didn't. Since you care so much now, I feel like you must be on that. So
that's Boosie, bro.
Like,
y'all Boosie. Y'all
be
Boosie.
With that nigga.
Nah, oh, guys, since you care so much,
go be mental.
Okay, master manipulator.
I'm not manipulating nothing, bro.
Go manipulate.
A lot of these niggas.
Me manipulating you is
up in the head.
Go be fucked up in the head with
that nigga. Me exactly. Shit, where it's like
since you care so much.
Now, hold up,
because when the last time you asked me about my nigga?
Yeah, bitch, you know what I'm saying? Yeah,
but
shit,
that's just one thing. Hold on. But that's just one thing, because on some other shit, I just feel like I said, since you care so much, you must be on that now. You hear me? And so, so I'm like,
because
it's like, why you care? What the fuck he feeling? You hear me? Like, I don't understand.
That's literally like me. That's like okay, me having check. A nigga me, and this me nigga asking, why do I care about hold how up. Y'all feel?
Me manipulating is me saying like, oh.
That's not manipulative.
It's me trying. Now, if I start trying to like that's break up with you or some shit. Like, oh.
Insecure, maybe.
Now you can't talk to him
okay,
no more.
Okay, so answer me this.
Insecure, maybe.
I'm going to tell you why it's insecure and why it's manipulative.
It's insecure, maybe.
You can sit there and say, if the nigga's, what do you say? If the nigga's sad, go be sad with him type shit.
No, he said.
So answer me this.
What's so wrong with that?
Fuck the sad. It was the mental.
If the niggas fucked up in the head, that's he's like, hey, on some shit where it's like, hey, I care about you genuinely as a friend. Hey, you no, good, just, whatever the fuck, no, whatever the fuck.
All right, this is what it is.
Y'all saying the bitch gotta go.
No. This is what it is with me. It depends.
Exactly. That's what me. You literally just said, I genuinely care about you. Okay, go be with the nigga.
Oh, me. The fuck, what are you talking about, bro?
I read some messages when I got out of jail. I ain't gonna get too deep into
type shit, type shit.
You feel me? But on some gang shit, like if you care this much, I like it's to the point where you be like, do you love this nigga or something?
Like, you know,
I'm some shit. In hand.
Because it's like, do you love this nigga or something? Because like, if you
love must
nigga,
love him.
It ain't enough love in your heart for both of us, bro.
I don't care how. I don't care how much.
If I love you, I'm in love.
I put this on. Go back to my point.
I put this on my four children.
Y'all can't say that though. Y'all cannot say that. That's like saying I got a nigga and a nigga tell and I'm checking on one of y'all. And a nigga telling me, oh, if you care that much, go be with them.
Which one?
I don't have a relationship with majority of y'all. I don't.
He wouldn't be wrong.
He would not be wrong.
Because how do he know this? Because you said so? How do he know this?
That's Boosie, bro.
Nah, it is not bias. It's not bias.
I said it's Boosie.
Boosie and bias is the same thing because I know why you're saying it. But what I'm saying.
The only reason I'm saying
it is because who it's coming from. You feel me? But what I'm saying is. What I'm saying is, bro, it's just. Y'all ever seen The Best Man?
That's different. You know that.
Next question.
All right, hold on.
Next question.
I'm gonna tell you where it's different.
Bro. Can I go first?
Nigga, go ahead.
Friend group.
Go ahead.
We all be gay.
No, real shit, bro. Cause you
later on
shit.
Down the line.
Nah, bro.
Later on down the line, I know I hit this shit.
All right, go ahead.
But your husband is just supposed to be good people. You feel me? Like, this your nigga. It ain't my nigga. This your nigga.
You on bullshit. I'm going to tell you why you on bullshit.
Time out again?
No, you good. But I'm going to tell you why you on bullshit.
Time out. That's crazy.
Just because, nigga, she had more than one nigga friend in that movie.
But it's me, though.
But it's me.
This is what I'm saying. So, like you just said, we good peoples. Like, I cracked that motherfucker, but we just friends.
So let me ask you something.
Don't ask me no bullshit.
So how? Now ask him some bullshit.
Don't ask
him
no
bullshit.
We're Biden.
I just want to know.
What?
So say like your woman asks her homeboy this, but he not in a friend group. This is her man's. How would you feel about that?
He not feeling that shit. This is D'Angelo.
I'm just potting.
What? Nah, you just potting now.
I'm not going for that shit.
He just potting now.
He played devil's advocate. That's what that is.
This is her.
I'm gonna keep it on being with you. My bitch got a homeboy that's cool with her now. Bitch, you better not talk to that nigga. What are you talking about? I don't give none of that.
No, my shorty got a homeboy.
You better not talk to that nigga. You better not even check on niggas' mental health. You better not check on niggas' mental health. I don't give a fuck none of that shit. I was just pod. No, that's my bitch.
I got a
her brother.
No, bro, I'll beat that nigga up.
Bro.
I got a bitch. She called this nigga her brother, bro. I swear to God, that boy.
Don't do it. That brother shit.
I'd be ready to snap that bitch's neck.
I was trying to have
it's the best friend shit that fuck.
Nah, I ain't gonna lie. That best friend shit is more.
Nah, my brothers are really my brothers.
I'm not gonna hold you.
I feel like.
How did
you pull up?
All right, well, yeah. Like, your nigga was there.
I feel like when a nigga and a female call each other best friend, they could be most likely getting it busted too. But they're most likely to, they probably could be just best friends. I'm more likely to believe that than that brother and sister.
Once they when you around, you but when you ain't around,
our brother, we done seen
down.
Some shit, boy.
I'm telling y'all, boy, y'all better stop getting played out.
Nah.
He's a bitch.
No.
Cut the cameras. I can't even say what the fuck I was about to say.
You can't fully subscribe to that?
No, I can't fully subscribe to that.
To what?
What you just said.
Y'all better stop getting played out.
Nah, because... Everybody cover their mic real quick.
Nigga, that shit on.
Oh, fuck.
We're covering for camera purposes.
The fact that everybody covered their mic, though, is crazy.
Every family members you be having, you ain't know what slut, so like the shit happened. Niggas be like, oh, damn, I didn't know they was slutty. Like, I didn't know.
Wait, say that again.
Like, you be having family members you didn't know was slutty. Until like the slutty shit happened. And then it's like, oh, well, shit. I mean, I guess they slutty. What do they do?
What?
What are we talking
how
about?
How we get yeah,
you know saying here?
I mean, if I got a slutty cousin, I can't do nothing about that. That's on her. I love my cousin, but you know, what she do is what she do. I ain't gonna knock her.
It mostly be.
I might like, kick it with her more, cause bitch, you got all the sluts with you too.
No, I know
you
do. Yeah, I ain't 19, gonna knock her shit. You can't be a slut. We like, grown.
When all the bullshit come out,
me, he gonna my stuff. Look at him. Yeah, trying to be a some weird shit.
Alright.
That was hate.
Yeah, friendly.
That was hate. That's hate. It's a lot of hate going on.
Hey.
It's a lot of hate.
Yo, twins y'all. Are proud slut.
Right?
On me.
Don't talk about you like that, bro. You're not a homie. All y'all basically saying is that he get bitches.
On me.
Wait, if you're a twin slut, don't tell me y'all sluts too.
Twin Skeetle.
Nah, to them, not me.
Nah, Shay definitely my slut twin. I don't even know why she playing.
Like, Slutterbond Shay is
oh, God.
Slutterbond Shay.
You heard it here first. On me.
Tramp stamp it.
On me.
Merchant.
Tramp stamp it. That would be so crazy.
Shay, nah.
Shay, boy, you diabolical, boy.
I was about to say something, but we on mics. Goddamn.
Yeah, don't be going for that. Hey, if your boyfriend or your girlfriend got a brother or a sister, yeah, dead that shit. I'm telling you.
What if they live like longer?
Don't give a fuck.
I'm gonna keep it all being with you. I don't nah.
So you had a home.
So you don't believe like if they tell you that it's blood, y'all don't believe they blood.
Girl, y'all never did nothing. It never been sexual, whatever case.
And I'm supposed to believe it because you said so.
I had to cut that bitch off.
You gonna cut your friend off?
Yes, I had to cut that bitch off.
I got a question.
And you know exactly what the fuck I'm talking about. I had a homegirl. We've been cool since sophomore year of high school. I ain't never hit that bitch. None of that shit. Don't even want to hit the bitch. I'm not even cool with that bitch right now, bro. My brother should be fucked.
Okay.
So y'all don't believe that they be blood.
Who?
Brother and sister.
No, if your mama ain't never seen them, if your mama ain't.
If your mama or your daddy ain't produce them, that's not your brother.
Yeah, that's not your people, bro.
I legit have a best friend, and we grew up together. My grandma raised her.
Okay, it's different.
You feel me? We ain't probably burnt them jeans when we was kids, but.
Burnt them jeans.
You know what I'm talking about.
I know what you mean.
But as grown ups, like, we ain't never been on that. Like, we literally was raised as this, that. All right, I got a question, though. Alright, it's both sides. You fucking with a nigga and you fucking with a bitch. Mm. A woman. Mm. You fucking with a man, you fucking with a woman.
Little boy.
His baby mama die.
Bitch, you better not call
her. Her baby daddy die. Would you be mad if she was like fucked up about it?
No. Nah. It's the parent of their child. No, nah, grieve. Nah. Grieve and I can't do nothing but be there.
Nah. It's a parent of your child, so I understand why you got kind of
if it was just
shit.
A little
but if it's her ex.
But like if she just like fucked up, like.
Oh, God. You got a certain amount of time to grieve like that before you got to get the fuck up and get it together.
It is a time limit, though.
Y'all are so.
I'll.
Like how long?
Like that boohooing and shit.
You can't boohoo though. That's like, the fucked up part about it.
Is we still fucking tonight though?
No.
Hell no.
No, I'm not going for that. If we're not fucking tonight still, no, I'm not going for that.
That is so selfish.
Call what you want. I'm not going for it. Nah, I'm not going
we're
for
not,
it.
We're not for real though on some real shit though. Because certain like
if my kids just like, lost their daddy was and worried about fucking mama,
yes.
If something was getting shit though. If something was happening to my baby mama, I bet not shed a tear around my woman.
Y'all sitting there talking about, like, y'all talking about y'all need that, so what y'all gonna do if y'all get that and the bitch just start crying mid-stroke? Like, y'all fuck it, and she just start boo-hooing. Like,
nigga, I'm leaving.
Because you need
oh,
that.
God, what are you talking about? Like, no, you're leaving. Something weird. No,
it's not. I'm saying y'all talking about y'all need that and shit, and the bitch is grieving.
No.
Grief comes and goes at any point, any time.
This shit over with. You think about this nigga wanna bust you the walls in?
Oh,
bitch, you through.
It's a bigger issue. It's a bigger issue.
Nah, when you put it like that, you are a
cook.
You
are a cook.
I'm still in love with that nigga.
Oh, God.
We here. We doing our intimate thing, and you start crying thinking about this nigga.
Damn, Gina.
Bitch. Listen, I'm going back to grandma.
I got grandsires. My
like, are you thinking about a time when y'all was getting it on or something? Like,
yep. Mm-hmm. Ooh, she thinking about when they made that
party?
Baby on me.
We probably
y'all did.
Nigga,
no.
Do your thing.
Next question.
Nigga, I had an ex of mine, nigga. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Go nigga, I'm with a bitch at the time. I can't even, nigga. She pulled up on me that day.
Yeah.
This nigga called me like, hey, nigga, you hear about the, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Huh? No
fuck
way,
you up.
Jose. No way.
Wait, so she was with you when I called you?
Nigga, no. She put on me 30 minutes after that.
Not one of your
damn.
Main.
So, I'm in there eating milk and cookies.
So listen, not one of your main dookie stains.
No, it's like. No. This was like.
Was it your main dookie stain?
This was like, nigga, my.
Yeah, was she your main dookie stain?
My main dookie stain at the time.
At the time?
At the time.
Wait a minute. Was you dealing with other people?
Why the fuck are you calling your bitch a dookie stay?
We're talking about the one that passed away, or we talking about?
Oh God, yeah.
I understand.
The one that passed away.
Yeah.
The one that passed away was like mom. That was my little. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
At the time.
Yeah.
At the time, I was with someone else.
That's what I'm saying. But she was your side. Yeah, yeah.
Nah, she's my main. Yeah, yeah. At the time,
and you was fucking with somebody else. Yeah, man, you got me confused, bro.
On me now?
You had to have just been there to do what I'm saying.
Okay, okay.
So anywho.
Oh, so y'all had one of them locked in type situations.
You dig what I'm saying?
So y'all was here with it.
We was here with it.
But she wasn't your main dookie shit.
You dig what I'm saying?
Respect. Okay, respect.
So nigga, at the time I'm with a chick or whatever like that. It's probably like wintertime or some shit like that, nigga.
But you hurt forever, nigga.
Ain't that what y'all call me?
No.
Bro, yeah, the girl that he was with, he wasn't even supposed to be with her.
I like her.
We went on a two man.
Yeah.
And it lasted way longer than it was supposed to.
Damn. Shit, drunk.
Then a motherfucker. Then it should have.
And it lasted way, they both did. So yeah.
Then it should have, bro. And
no, you should have felt some way.
Boy, I'm in the car. She's talking about, you want to smoke? I'm like, yeah. Fuck yeah, I want to smoke.
That nigga feel the end.
Hell yeah, like this shit up.
Boy, what? She's like, you good? I'm like, yeah.
Are you good? I can see her saying that shit.
I got smoke in my eye.
Boy, I'm glad I got smoke in my eye. I'm in there like, I can't believe.
What was the appropriate time frame?
Nigga, I still had to crack buns that night.
I'm sure that made it a little better, though.
I still had to crack it down.
Selfish.
She didn't know.
No, she didn't know what was going on. I didn't tell her nothing. Hell no.
It's like,
I was thinking about telling her, but I'm just picking the vibe. She had attitude. I'm like,
is you supposed to go to your woman like, man, fuck. My baby mama died.
My favorite hoe died.
She gonna be like, nigga, and?
Give a fuck. Pussy.
Eat this pussy.
Pussy. Put this big toe in your mouth, nigga.
Bitch, you ass
nigga.
All right,
nigga.
That bitch out.
You really did care about her though.
The one? Yeah. But that's either hitting. I got somebody to care about now.
That's insane.
Yeah, but wait. And that motherfucker sick as hell. Smoking a Swisher blunt. I mean, they're irritated as fuck.
Smoking a Swisher.
Hey, you just like, let me play a song. Man, I miss my dogs. That motherfucker getting cinchy.
Man. Wouldn't pot it today.
Do y'all feel like when y'all women playing music, speaking out music?
Yes.
She talking shit?
Yes.
Yeah. But see, I'm the type of nigga that I don't care about that type of shit. If this song slap, what's the name of this?
I'm singing with it.
Now I'm about to be playing this motherfucker. The fuck?
And I'm about to turn
that song gonna slap. Fuck that nigga with the faces dropping with your punk ass.
I don't care about none of that shit. You sitting there playing some sad shit. I'm like, hey, what's the name of this song?
Which one? I should have cheated.
By Keisha Cole?
Yeah, she cannot play that.
I'm musically rounded.
Like I fuck with the slaps. So like I'm going to piss you off because I'm being that motherfucker sleeping.
As soon as I get mad, I'm gonna want to play Boogeyman or some J-Bo or something. And I'm gonna start plotting on how I'm gonna dismember your body.
She cannot play that Keisha Cole by far. No,
I ain't gonna hold them in there violating if she pissed me off.
No, yeah, I'm going to slam you.
I'm going to violate.
If I should have cheated, came on.
Nah, I should have cheated. Might do it.
Nah.
Or what's that song with? It's by Queen Isaac when she started listing off the nigga's name. She could have got naked for it.
I should have fucked on Brian. I should have fucked on Devontae.
I should have sucked little David Dick.
Lorenzo
and shit.
No. Like, man, because the bitches start singing that shit hard, bro. And I'm like, oh, so you wanted to suck a nigga dick, hoe?
Yeah.
All right. Bet.
I come out the room like Rodney.
I'm about to go bust something down right now. What? Got it.
You ain't gonna have no hardcore proof.
Do it like Ronnie did Dean. I'm trying to tell you.
Bitch, two can play that game, hoe.
Give me Ike.
Did y'all hear that shit? I said I'm gonna black your eye. That nigga said give you a black eye. What would you do if I sing, got a tune, give you a black eye? Hey, that shit's crazy, bro.
He was fucking that bitch down, bro. That's
real up.
It's real love.
I mean, for the night.
Oh, no, wait. If we're going to be objective here, let's be objective. What's love got to do with it was not a real biopic. Tina Turner said it herself in her book. She said she was beating that nigga ass. She's like he was beating her ass. They was either beating each other up and doing coke.
They only showed her hit it.
I promise you. He said, I done read her biopic, watched her documentary, look, all that shit.
They said, okay, when he used to beat the bitch up,
big fan.
He used to fuck her out of guilt. So like, damn, I should have did that. But he said that. But in the movie, he socked the bitch up and raped her. Like, God, I mean, graped her. I mean, did some foul shit to it, my bad. But not real shit. God, yeah, it was crazy. It was crazy, but he like did an interview like, I ain't never did no shit to her like
it's just that. Like the Bobby and Whitney shit. Bobby introduced that fucking coke to that woman. Whitney Houston was running around with a junkie.
I swear to God. EB and Tara had a conversation about this.
Whitney Houston like, was
a junkie?
Yes.
She was like, hell
fucking Ray J and some more shit.
She was a junkie. Like, nigga, she was on that man, shit. Bro.
Wow.
Nigga, they walked in that room. He walked in that room. She was in that motherfucker getting sitchy. She was like, they tried to take the plate from her. She like, nah. She looked down at it and said, this me.
This me.
And he like, shit, what that shit hitting for? Nigga started getting sitchy with her.
Okay, so y'all smoke.
Yeah.
Can y'all, like, y'all, what if your woman do other drugs?
Nah, she got good pussy. Nah.
She got what?
Good pussy.
Bitch, what other drugs is she doing?
Bitch, fuck like a
meth.
No, fuck no. Meth is crazy.
Nah, one thing about it, though, the females who be like,
what if she's, drinking what if she's lean a functioning addict?
What if she tooting?
Oh, no.
She tooting? She told me.
Listen,
I'm scared of them type of people.
Tony Montana.
Their bitch is going to beat your ass.
I
ain't
in a different field of work.
Like, I ain't going to lie. I don't
crack the powder sniffer, and I might I say bullshit.
Yeah, crazy.
That motherfucker like an Energizer crazy. Bunny.
And pill poppers.
On me.
Pill poppers?
Exy. Boy, that bitch fuck like a pro. That bitch
them
fuck
grown
like,
man
that
thing.
Bitch throw that pussy like she don't want it no more. You hear me? That bitch be in there fucking.
Oh. No, bro. You ever heard some perk pussy?
Yeah,
perk pussy.
No, I don't play that perk shit.
I don't play that perk. You said you what you did?
I definitely didn't crack.
She was on that.
She was. Yeah, I ain't did no perk pussy, bro. But I will say, I had this white lady. Yeah, man.
What you gonna say now?
Listen,
the only thing I ever did was crack a girl off and she was off the shrooms.
Sounds like.
Bro.
And she looked like she was enjoying that shit.
This is way before my relationship. Way, you know, far back.
Type shit.
Nigga, she used to pop pills. Let's say that. So, pull up on her, you know what I mean? She crushed that motherfucker down, snorted it. I'm like, straight up. She like, she got her nose right. She like, shit, you know a spot we can go to? I'm like,
bitch,
what you
feeling frisky?
I'm like, what you mean? Boy, we at Waffle House on Front Street, nigga. I'm trying to fight this white lady off of me. She like, come on. Ooh, I know it's, yeah. Like, it's, I'm like,
bitch,
I'm
hand me.
Like, it's little. Leave me alone. You feel me? Like, boy, I'm trying, nigga, the doors is locked, nigga. And if you know, if you've been in the Ford Fusion, boy, it's a light. It's not a lock. You feel me? I'm at that motherfucker trying to.
I know exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah, bro, and she and that motherfucker horny, like, trying to put that motherfucker on me, but. I don't like raw chicken.
It was this one time, bro, I flew out to Philly, nigga, and was fucking with this little bitch or whatever like that. And, like, I swear to God, I think she went to the bathroom and did a line, bro.
She came back, activated.
What, nigga?
Literally getting your pants. That,
nigga, I'm like, I'm 19, 20 at the time, so I'm still young, nigga. Don't ask no questions.
I was about to say something.
Don't ask. Go ahead. Don't ask nothing, nigga. Just get out there. But nah, 19, 20 around the time, I'll get out there, nigga, and... Yeah, like I said, the bitch went to the bathroom and came back a different animal, nigga. Yes, touchy feely, like, bitch, what are you doing? What's up with you?
Brother,
Brother, stop. Brother, stop. What's going on?
I don't like aggressive bitches.
And I'm I ain't even halfway to the blunt yet, so I ain't even got my mold yet. Like, I'm walking, you know what I mean? It's like the blunt gets got sparked. I'm like, gets got into the motherfuckers, just hitting good. She come out, hey, what's going on? Let me touch your bitch. Move. Get your head off my dick.
Yeah, it's soft right now.
Pop the fuck out her hand. My dick's off right now.
I definitely done pop the bitch, cause bitch, you're handsy as fuck, ho. At a point you get the feeling like meat, like pause.
I'm not a whore.
Like a whole bunch of horny bitch, like a bitch get real horny and you ain't on that. She gets trying to, like, if you had breakaway pants, you would be naked. Like, for real.
Smash them hoes off.
Yeah, real shit.
What happened?
Hey, like, brother.
We pod today, yo. We gotta get out of here, bro. Do y'all own outros, man. Tell who the fuck y'all is, man.
It's your boy, Dontego Casanova, a.k.a. Miss Lady at Goodwood, a.k.a. Monitor of Misfit Podcast.
Shit, man. Big D-Lo money, man. The real D-Lo money.
Shit. Angelo Corleone, this motherfucker, big CEO shit, man. Popular ignorance type shit. You know the vibes.
right now. Man, a real heck, Loke. Your baby mama's favorite. Your mama's favorite. Somebody's favorite. Yeah, this bitch is shit.
Brother, yeah.
You hear me?
Hey, y'all. It's me. Y'all know me. Skinny Winnie.
Fuck Casper.
I'm dead. You, do you know who Skinny Me is?
A big slut.
Type shit.
That's who that's Skinny Me is?
Do y'all know who the guy is?
No, I was talking about my...
Why are you over there talking about me?
Do y'all outros. Let's get out this motherfucker.
Eight quarters. $2.
$2. Stop it, $2.
And y'all can follow me on everything at Milani Yvette.
Y'all can follow me on everything. Yvette.
That be that masculine energy for sure. Yeah,
y'all can follow me on all that shit.
Man, tell them about your show coming up. Take over. And then we out this motherfucker.
July 13th. Y'all can catch me at the Juke opening up for Cuzzo Fly.
You. July 13th. Y'all can catch me at the Juke opening up for Mr. Don't Spill It. You hear me? Come fuck with your boy. You hear me? Hey, it's a good show. For everybody that done seen me perform, it's a good show. I be dancing with my fat ass. You hear me? Poblock.
Nah, we out this motherfucker, man. See you niggas next week.
I'm drunk.
Oh, did you say O-Block?
I said Foblock.
Oh, I was about to be weak. Crazy. That nigga O-Block right now.
O-Blocky? Ain't that what he called me?